Hello everyone, this is Monica Lupion and today I will solve the example included in the lecture Fundamentals of Mass Transfer. First, just a quick summary of the different equations that we review during the lecture. This is the fixed rate equation where we can calculate the molar flux of the element A, which is equal to the molar flux resulting from the concentration gradient plus the molar flux corresponding to the bulk motion contribution. In order to be able to use that equation, we need to get an estimation of the diffusivity, of the diffusion coefficient. And we saw different cases for when we had different gases or when there was a mass transfer in the liquid phase. We studied different equations or empirical equations that will help us to determine the values of this diffusivity. In the case of the gas phase, with three different ways of calculating or estimating this coefficient. For the liquid phase, we also saw two different methodologies. One is Stokes-Einstein and the second one is the Wilkie-Chan. In general, it was important to highlight that the diffusivity, the coefficient diffusion of A through B in general is not the same as the coefficient of the diffusivity of B in A for liquids, while in the gases these two coefficients were the same. So this is the example. I would like you to stop the video for a few minutes and read through the problem and try to understand all the different data and the features provided. A gas separation process has been proposed to remove selectively two pollutants, hydrogen sulfide and sulfur dioxide, from an exhaust gas stream containing 3% molar the hydrogen sulfide and 5% molar of sulfur dioxide, and the rest is nitrogen. The temperature is 350 Kelvin and the total pressure is 1 atmosphere. We need to calculate the total molar concentration, the molar concentration of hydrogen sulfide, and mass concentration of hydrogen sulfide. Then we need to estimate the binary gas phase molecular diffusion of hydrogen sulfide in nitrogen. And in order to do that, there are two values provided. One is the critical temperature of hydrogen sulfide, which is 73.2 Kelvin. And the critical volume as well is 98.5 cubic centimeter per mole. The third section is to estimate the molecular diffusion coefficient of the hydrogen sulfide in the gas mixture. So not only how the hydrogen sulfide diffuses through nitrogen, but through the gas mixture. And then we have to compare this value of the molecular diffusion coefficient in the gas mixture. We need to compare the value with the value that we got from the section B, which was related to the diffusivity of hydrogen sulfide in nitrogen. Okay, so let's begin by drawing a diagram. So this is a multi-component mixture where we have three different species involved. A, which is the hydrogen sulfide, B, which is the nitrogen, and C, which is the sulfur dioxide. We know we can have the molecular weight of these three different species because we know the chemical formulation, and also the fraction, the molar fraction of A, B, C are also indicated in the problem. 3% of hydrogen sulfide, 5% of sulfur dioxide, and the rest is nitrogen, which is 92%. We also know the value of the temperature and the pressure, and finally the critical temperature and the volume. So first section is to determine the concentration, the total concentration, the concentration of A, and the density of hydrogen sulfate. You can review the table that we study in the lecture 10 and the fundamentals of mass transfer, where there were different ways of expressing the concentration and the molar fraction, and how can we calculate the fixed rate equation depending on the concentration of the molar fraction. In this case, the concentration is directly calculated assuming that is ideal gas, so we can directly apply the ideal gas equation. So the concentration is equal to the pressure over the constant R times T, the temperature. We know the value of the pressure, the temperature, and using these units as a reference, we can also get the value of R. We do the calculations, and the concentration is equal to 34.8 mole per cubic meter. Once we know the concentration, we can also calculate the concentration of A, of the hydrogen sulfide. And in this case, it's very simple because we know the total concentration, and we also know the molar fraction. We just have to multiply the molar fraction by the total concentration. So the concentration of hydrogen sulfide is 1.04 mole per cubic meter. Finally, the density of the hydrogen sulfide is also relatively simple. Once we know the concentration of A, we just have to multiply this concentration by the molecular weight of 8 of hydrogen sulfide. And as a result of the calculations, we know that the density is equal to 35.4 grams per cubic meter. Okay, so section A is already solved. Let's move to the section B. The section B, we need to estimate the diffusion coefficient of the hydrogen sulfide through the nitrogen. We just review different empirical equations to determine this coefficient, and this is the equation in view of the data that we have. This is the equation that we need to apply. So in this equation here is the diffusion coefficient of A through B, and it's equal to a constant times the temperature raised to 3/2 power times the inverse of the molecular weight of A and B raised to 1/2, and then over the pressure over the alpha of A and B square times omega, which is the collision parameter that we can find in appendix K. So let's see the information, the values that we got for some of these parameters and the ones we don't have. Let's see how we can calculate those. So alpha A is relatively simple to calculate because we have this volume here, which is a value provided by the problem. So the alpha A is equal to 3.884 angstrom. For this epsilon over kappa, which is the Boltzmann constant, this is also relatively easy because we know the critical temperature of A, which is data provided by the problem. And as a result, this is equal to 287.4 Kelvin. We also need to calculate, in order to determine alpha AB, we know alpha A, but we need to know the value of alpha B, which we can get from the appendix K, from table K2. We can get these two parameters, the Lehner-Jones parameter alpha and this epsilon over kappa. If you remember from lecture 10, we study that this Lehner-Jones parameter in a binary system can be calculated by the average of the alpha A and the alpha B, being A and B the two species involved. So that's what we're doing here. So as a result, this alpha AB is equal to 3.78 angstroms. The same for the second parameter. We know the kappa, well, we know epsilon over kappa for these two, for the element A and the element B. We also know the temperature, so this value here is equal to 2.16. Why we need to know this value here? Because we can use this value here to get into table K1 and get the value of this collision parameter omega. In this case, well, this value here doesn't correspond directly with an entry in the table, so we need to make an interpolation. This value of omega is 1.047. So we have all the elements that we need. We need the we know the temperature, we need the molecular weight, we know the pressure, we know the Lehner-Jones parameter, and we know these collision parameters here. Therefore, the diffusion coefficient of A in B is equal, after making all the calculation, this is equal to 0.207 centimeters square centimeter per second. Okay, now the last section is to estimate the diffusion coefficient of A, but instead of the in hydrogen, we want to know what's the value of the coefficient of the diffusion coefficient of A in the mixture gas. So considering as well the sulfur dioxide. Also from the lecture 10, we study an equation where we can get the value of the diffusivity through a mixture. In this case, we can directly use this equation here, and there is a parameter, y prime, which we can define if we know the molar fraction of the different species involved. Let's do the example, and I think it will be much more clear. From this equation here, it's clear that we need to know the diffusion of the element A in B and the diffusion of the element A in C. We know already the diffusion of element A in B because we already solved the section B. So now in this section first, we need to calculate the diffusion coefficient of the element A in C. C, in this case, is the sulfur dioxide. We're going to use the same equation as we used in section B, but of course now the values are referred to the element A and the element C. We look for the different Lehner-Jones parameters in the appendix K for the sulfur dioxide. And once we know these two values, we are able to calculate alpha A and C as the average of the alpha A and alpha C, which is 4.09 angstrom. Now the second Lehner-Jones parameter, And it's the same methodology that we use in section B, but instead of having A and B, now we have A and C. These omega, these collision parameters, we can calculate it from table K1, since this is 1.30. We have now all the elements we need. We have the temperature, we have the molar weights, we have the pressure, we have the alpha, and we have the omega. So doing the calculations, the diffusion coefficient of A in C is equal to 0.12 square centimeter per sec. So in order to apply this equation here, if now we know the value of the diffusivity of A in B and the diffusivity of A and C, we need to calculate this Y prime, which is based on the molar fractions. We know the molar fractions for the hydrogen sulfide was 3%, for the sulfur dioxide was 5%, and nitrogen is the rest, which is 92%. So during the calculations, and the result is that the diffusion coefficient of A in the mixture gas is equal to 0.20. If you compare this value with section B, in section B, the value of the diffusion coefficient was equal to 0.207. So it's very similar. There is a difference because now we are considering SO2, the sulfur dioxide, as well, while in section B it was only hydrogen sulfide and nitrogen. So it's not exactly the same because of that, but it's very close because the nitrogen is the predominant gas. It's the larger content, the larger percentage. So that's why it's very similar, but it's not exactly the same because in section C, we are considering the sulfur dioxide as well.